Yeah.
The Himalayan kingdom of Bhutan is experiencing a shortage of vegetables. Although the country is largely agrarian, local farmers do not produce enough greens to meet domestic demand. But since mid-2012, the authorities have restricted vegetable imports from neighbouring India due to diminishing rupee reserves. And while the currency outflow has been stemmed, consumers and food businesses have to cope with a lack of vegetables.
In the market, we have vegetables in the market. We have less vegetables in the market. Bhutan. Then we have all the vegetables in the market.
To counter the shortage, the government has launched an ambitious plan to make all the local farms organic by the end of this decade.
By default, nearly 60 to 70% of our farming is already organic. Farmers do not use any chemicals, fertilizers and so on already. It's just that we do not have a certification system saying that this is organic.
Organic farming trials have been implemented by several farm cooperatives. These involve the introduction of techniques like mixed cropping and the use of all-natural pesticides made from cattle urine and wild plants. But while organic farming is eco-friendly, there are concerns the move may worsen the vegetable shortage, as organic farms tend to have lower yields than conventional ones. Some also fear that with the new measure, Bhutan's goal of achieving food self-sufficiency by 2015 would be harder to reach. Compounding the challenge for the farming sector, few young people are keen to work in the fields.
Our population, you know, is not even 1 million. And with that, more than half being employed in either in schools or government services or corporate thing, farming population is decreasing. So it is a huge challenge.
Consumer response to local organic produce has also been poor due to their higher prices and unappealing appearance. Aware of these factors, the government admits its vision for local farms won't be easy to realise.
For example, rice. You know, if all the Bhutanese people, as we are doing now, keep on eating 3 times, 4 times of rice a day, we will never be able to produce enough. So we will still need to import certain quantity of rice.
The authorities are now placing their hopes on young Bhutanese like Sungay Runchen, who has a diploma in agriculture. He's among the new breed of farmers who's keen to lead the way in organic agriculture.
Some years from now, we'll have this country whole organic. And even if we cannot produce for the export and then for the rest of the world, we'll be growing enough for ourselves and we'll live in harmony with nature. That is what I see.
And if this trademark Bhutanese optimism can carry the day, the kingdom can look forward to even more healthy and tastier vegetables.